Would you like to know how to record receiving rent payments from tenants in your management service company? Well, then you should watch this video, Recording Rent Collections. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. How do we record receiving rent from tenants? Well, first, we use the Receive Payments window. We input the specific date, amount, and tenant. Then we choose which bank account that the tenant's money was deposited into. And that's it. It's that easy. Quick note before I demonstrate how to record receiving rent payments. Normally, we would collect a security deposit from each tenant before or at the moment we collect the first month's rent. In fact, we would even collect a security deposit from each landlord before we start up. Those videos are coming in a future video very soon. So soon I will show you exactly how to record all security deposit type transactions. But to get the idea of how a management company operates day to day, I'm showing receiving the rent payment first. So we're going to stick to this very simple three-step plan. Example one. Let's imagine on January 1 of 2022, we received $3,000 for January's rent from Betty Boop, who is a tenant under the landlord, Alan Arby. Now, this is our very first transaction. So the trial balance is blank. But if we receive $3,000 from rent from a tenant, what will change? Well, we have $3,000 in the bank now, so cash and bank will show up for the first time as $3,000, and rent payable to landlord clients is the reason we have that $3,000, because that $3,000 will have to be paid to the landlord clients. So it's money we owe, it's a liability with a credit balance, and $3,000 will show up on the credit side for the very first time. Let's follow the three-step plan and see if we get the same result. We can even open the trial balance before we record the transactions and maybe change the columns a little to make it look nice. We just follow the three-step plan and open the payment window from the icon bar. We choose Betty Boop under the landlord Alan Arby. We put the date as January 1 of 2022. Make sure you choose the correct bank account. You know, you only have to do this once if it's always going to be the same bank account. Choose the bank account the money's going into, and now all you have to do is put the money amount. When you type it in, after you type in the zeros, push the tab key because that will save the field but keep the window open. If everything looks good, then at the very bottom, you might not be able to see it in my screen, but at the very bottom there's a save and close window right here. Now you're going to get this message about a payment credit. Just click OK. And when we go to the trial balance, you can see that cash in bank is exactly as what we expected, and this liability account indicating what we owe to pay back to the landlord whose tenant we just collected rent from shows up for the first time as $3,000. Now, what about example two? January 1, still the beginning of the month, we received $4,000 for January's rent from Candy Charles under Alan Arby. So if we received $4,000 from a second tenant under the same landlord in the same day, What will be the result? Well, we'll have 4,000 more in the bank, so we have 7,000 here, and we owe 4,000 more to clients in general. So let's record it the same way. Open the payment window. Notice it remembers cash in bank. It remembers the last date we recorded a transaction, but this time it's Candy under Allen for 4,000. Push tab. Now again, you could just hit the enter key, and again, we will talk about this payment credit feature later. But for now, click OK, and the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. However, the most important results show up right here in the most important report, Landlord Payout Balances. If you click, this report will clearly show you that on January 1, we received rent from Betty for $3,000. On January 1, we received rent from Alan for $4,000. Therefore, at this moment, the total that we owe to Alan Arby, the landlord, is $7,000. And you see how great this report is. It shows you the total to that specific landlord and the individual tenants that you collected from. But to really get the idea, let's do two more examples. Let's imagine we collected under the other landlord, Dave Deeney, from this guy, Eddie Edwards, $3,000 for Eddie under Dave Deeney. Well, if that were the next transaction, what would the trial balance look like? Well, we have 3,000 more in the bank, so that would go up to 7,000. And technically, we owe 3,000 more to our landlord clients for the rent that we just collected that we haven't given yet. So let's go ahead and record that. So, you know, we leave the trial balance first, open payment, still January 1, still cash in bank, but now it's a different landlord. It's this tenant, Eddie Edwards, and he just paid $3,000. Hit enter or go to the bottom and click OK. Click OK again or hit enter, close the window. And now you can see the result in the trial balance is exactly what we expected. But if you go to the most important report, Landlord Payout Balances, you can see we owe $7,000 to Alan for two tenants, and we owe $3,000 to Eddie for, we owe $3,000 to Dave Deeney, the landlord, for collecting Eddie. That's why the total is $10,000, and that's why at this moment the total we owe is $10,000. One last one, just to bring it home. Again under Dave Deeney, Dave's other tenant, Freddie Froda, paid $4,000. So what will be the final result in the trial balance? Well, you have $4,000 more in cash, so you have $14,000 in the bank, and you owe $4,000 more to landlords, so you have rent payable to clients, $14,000, excuse me. Same thing, payment, same bank account, same date, but this time it's Freddie Froda that you collected. And we hit enter again, close the window, and now you can see the total in the bank is $14,000. The total we owe back to landlords for now is $14,000. And why is it $14,000? That's because you can see it's because we owe Alan $7,000 for the two clients we collected from him. We owe Dave $7,000 for the two clients we collected from him. Therefore, we owe a total of $14,000, which equals what's in the trial balance, $14,000 rent payable to landlord client.